Problem two, a sequence of positive integers an begins with a1 equal to a and a2 equal to b for positive integers a and b. Subsequent terms in the sequence satisfy the following two rules for all positive integers n. a2n plus 1 is equal to a2n times a2n minus 1, and a2n plus 2 is equal to a2n plus 1 plus 4. Exactly m of the numbers a1, a2, a3 and so on up to a2022 are square numbers. What is the maximum possible value of m? Note that m depends on a and b. It's quite hard to see what these formulae are going to do. So what I'm going to start by doing is just choosing some values of a and b and working out some terms of the sequence and seeing what happens. I'm also worried that the multiplication is going to cause terms to get very large very quickly. So I'm going to start by taking a and b to be as small as I can, namely 1, the smallest positive integer. Now the rules say that the odd terms of the sequence, like a3, are formed by multiplying the previous two terms. So a3 is 1 times 1, which is 1. While the even terms of the sequence are formed by adding 4 to the previous term. So a4 is 1 plus 4, which is 5. So next we multiply the two previous terms. 1 times 5 is 5. We add 4 to get 9. We multiply 5 and 9 and get 45. And then we add 4 to get 49. Now, I really don't want to multiply 45 and 49 if I can help it. So for now, I'll just put a dot, 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 and I'll think about it if I have to later. I can see at once that there's quite a few squares here. So 1 is a square, and that occurs 3 times. 9 is 3 squared, and 49 is 7 squared. So I've got a few squares in there. I'll now calculate another example with different a and b, see what happens. I still want to keep them small, so this time I'll start with 1 and 2. Now what I get is that 1 times 2 is 2, 2 plus 4 is 6, 2 times 6 is 12, 12 plus 4 is 16, 12 times 16 is 192, and 192 plus 4 is 196. And I really don't want to multiply 192 and 196, so I'll stop there for now. Again, there are some squares, perhaps not as many. There's 1 at the beginning again, and then 16 is 4 squared, and 196 is 14 squared. So I've got some squares in each case, and one thing we can notice is that in both cases, the 6th and the 8th terms are both squares. It might be worth trying to prove that, and prove that it always happens, and maybe prove that even numbered terms after that are squares. And then that'll help us by telling us about what happens through most of the sequence. If I'm going to prove that the 6th term is a square, it's helpful to start thinking about the 3rd and 4th term. So of course, the 3rd term is obtained by multiplying together a and b. I don't care too much about that, so I'll just write that as k for the moment. Then the 4th term is obtained by taking that and adding 4 to it. And then the 5th term is obtained by multiplying those two together. So I get k times k plus 4. And then the 6th term is going to be obtained by adding 4 to that. So I get k times k plus 4 plus 4. Now, this has got a bit complicated, and I can simplify it a bit. And I get that this is equal to k squared plus 4k plus 4. And happily, that factorizes as a square. It's k plus 2 all squared. And that, in fact, proves that every term, every even term after the 6th is a square, because the 3rd and 4th terms are of this format, giving that the 6th term is a square. But the 5th and 6th terms are also going to be of this format, giving the 8th term a square. And the 7th and 8th terms are going to be in this format, giving the 10th term a square, and so on. So we've proved that, starting with the 6th term, every even term of this sequence is a square. I guess we also need to know that the odd terms are going to be not squares. And what we need to do is to think about the fact that they're 4 less than the term after. Now, if we look at the squares quickly, 1, 4, 9, 16, and so on. After 4, the gap between consecutive squares is more than 4. So the gap from 4 to 9 is 5, and after that it gets even bigger. So there's not going to be any squares that differ by 4 after 4. The gap between 4 and 0 is 4, but 0 is not positive, so it can't occur in the sequence. So there are no gaps of 4 between positive squares. And that means that given that the odd terms are 4 less than a square, they can't themselves be square. So we've worked out that the 6th, 8th, 10th terms and so on are all squares, whereas the 5th, 7th, 9th and so on are all not squares. All that remains to be done now is to think about what happens with the 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th terms. So let's think about the first four terms. So they're A, B, A times B and A times B plus 4. Now, as we've said, there are no positive squares that differ by 4, so we can't have AB and AB plus 4 both square, so we see at once that there can be at most 3 squares in this sequence. So if A was a square and B was a square, and one of A times B and A times B plus 4 was square, we'd have 3, and that'd be the most we could get in these four terms. But of course, if A is a square and B is a square, then A times B is automatically a square, and then A times B plus 4 will automatically not be a square. So what we've got is that we can get 3 terms of the first 4 squares by taking the first 2 to be squares. And that completely answers the question. So the maximum number of squares possible in the sequence consists of 3 of the first 4 plus half the remaining 2018 terms. And so 3 plus half of 2018 is 1,012, and that's the maximum possible number of squares.